Should be doing me now. I have no idea what the hell is going on. It's literally, it hasn't restarted for probably months. It's been on all day, non-stop, nothing. And just when I started streaming, it started restarting. Bizarre, isn't it? No. No, there's no blocks or anything. Plus, it wouldn't restart the PC. And I can't see anything that decisive either in the Windows logs. There's a few errors in here, but the thing is, distributed comms, which is, you get that quite often anyway. See service fail to an error, that's because it got blocked from loading. Services are serve dev. What is serve dev? See if I can figure out what that is. Yeah, so I don't know why it seems to be like every about 40 minutes, doesn't it? Goes for about 40 minutes and then just randomly crashes. Serve their system driver, system cannot be loaded, DRM. No problems on the weekend either, so it can't be any like security issue or anything. It's been working fine on the weekend. It was fine Saturday when I changed the hard drive over, and it was fine on Sunday as well, so... Right, it says power, but that's because basically it turned off. I don't know. Anything I could do again... I could wipe the TPM chip again. But didn't need to do it. No. Weird on, nothing all day. No, it's dead. It's literally just rebooted. And I can't really see why it's doing it. There's a WHE logger error. I'm not entirely sure what that is. Corrected hardware error security. And corrected hardware error. Let me quick search that a minute. But it's not coming up as a red, it's just coming up as a yellow. Corrected hardware security reported. Something called Microsoft say that is. Apparently processor specs not post correctly. Posted subject. Need the firmware updates in the BIOS and hasn't been like normal a week. I can't be anything like Axe, it's been working fine. Oh well, let's just try again, shall we? Yeah, it's been working fine, so literally it's been on all day. I literally haven't turned it off. I turned it on about 8 o'clock this morning, it's been on ever since. Okay. Let's just go with that then and see what the hell happens. If you can't put something on you that still pick up where it crashes. It's weird, isn't it? Just only when I started streaming. I wonder if it's the Elgato again. That caused problems last time, didn't it? But it wouldn't work. It wasn't like crashing. I had to literally delete the Elgato drivers. Literally take it all off and put it back on. Right, hang on a minute. Let me just get the chat back up and hopefully it don't go off. Like I say, if it goes off in about 40 minutes or something, then maybe we'll just leave it, call it a night at that point. But we'll see. Nah, it's definitely not a block, so... Oh, I forgot to turn it over. with the sound. Well, I don't get it. It's literally just been on all day. I suppose the only thing I haven't used all day is the Elgato. Hope that's not going for me, so I'll have to buy it. Let me get my sound going. It's a connected hardware error. Can't be that much problems with the Elgato because it's working. I think it just had a hissy fit because of the board. Ah, oh, I left my drink as well. Okay. What else did I chuck in here? So go to this Namco Museum. Go and grab another drink second, guys, while this is going. I'll be back in a minute. Right. What I could do, if it does it again, I could remove the Elgato hardware quickly. Not remove it out of the PC, just remove it on it. Reboot it, let it reinstall itself, and see if that fixes it. Right, I haven't tried this yet. It was like $5.99. Any bags, it's normally 30 quid. Like, who's going to read all this gimp? You've just bought the game. If you say no, basically you can't play it. So if I go no... No, I don't agree to any of that crap. So I can't play it. Right, okay. I like Galaga. Galaga. Tower of Duraga. Okay, kid. Rolling Thunder's class. That's a nice game, guys. Oh, yeah. This is why I want to pick this up. Hopefully, it's a good conversion. Tank Force. Same. Namco don't like it when I stream. I love that cover, it's cool as fuck. Not really played much of the arcade one, played the Mega Drive one, which is really good. Right, okay, let's try it out then. Normal challenge mode. Right, we're getting the options. Okay, what have we got then? Ah, right, okay, so layer one controls. Can I actually change the buttons? So I want that as jump, and I want that as attack. Okay. Let's try it. Yeah, that's why I picked it up, like... Yep. Shot in Galaga. Have a look at what screen modes you got now as well. Okay, whatever. How do you get back to... coin pause menu. Alright, I did press that belly button. Okay, so what screen modes you got? Display. Vertical position, aspect ratio. Ah, so you can stretch it. And you got scan lengths as well. Ooh, they look quite nice as well. Try the zoom in. See what the scan lines look like. Okay, they still work. Cool, turn them off. What else we got? Oh, it was bad, is it? Ah, that's not good. Oh, it's the Pac-Man one. Oh, yeah, the Pac-Man one was supposed to be quite bad, wasn't it? Alright, this seems alright. Yeah, loads of people were complaining about the Pac-Man game. Not getting any pixel crawl either, which is quite nice. This seems okay, actually. I'll try it. Oh, I didn't bloody get through it. Normally you can slide him. That was terrible. Trying to be cocky with the slide screwed me over. Oh well. Yeah, it seems right, it says actually. I wonder if Namco farmed the Pac-Man one out. Didn't do it in-house. I bet this PC will restart again. Won't do any. Yeah, I've played it a little bit. It seems not very nicely done. It's just got a little bit of softness to it, but nothing too crazy. You can still see the pixels on this, which is quite nice. I'm not sure if the colours look a little bit muted though. Could be just me. Quite cool to have this on the Switch handheld. Yeah, they must have palmed off to somebody else, I reckon. Right, I can never remember where to. I really don't know where to stand on the arcade one. What I do is normally stand. I think I've got to stand by here, wait for the glass to drop. And stand over here, maybe? Does that actually work? Yeah, it does. Okay, that's what you do. Yeah, especially if they're farming it out to somebody. And they're not Q&A-ing it, probably. You can't go that far wrong with Pac-Man, can you, to be honest? Probably run that on your bloody credit card these days. Welcome back. Hopefully we won't cut off again. The random reset's a bit of a pain. Wait, plum sided this time. Okay, that smells nice. Interesting. Ooh, that's nice as well. Mmm. Well, I got shit. Oh, that was a waste. Yeah, most modern consoles and computers have got a bit of lag, haven't they? Render time, like, if you know what I mean. Yeah, that's sounding pretty rough, isn't it, with that compilation? No wonder they've done a shit job at it. They've ripped off by the Final Burn. If they're going to rip off Final Burn, they do such a bad job at it. Obviously, they couldn't get Final Burn running properly on their Switch. And apparently the Australian guy does PGM stuff. One of the few of the ROMs that he'd ripped off the cartridges are actually on that collection as well. So they just did Nintendo by the look of it. Just went online and got the ROMs. I suppose technically Yeah, I'd love to do that, really, anyway. Yeah, they are games. VX is not like it, see? I wasn't expecting him to come out of that one then. I don't use it very often, no. I don't find it that reliable half the time. It takes a bit of practice to get good at it. I know you can basically slide through the game quite a bit if you learn to use it. But no, I hardly ever use it. It comes in handy with the chainsaw boss though, doesn't it? If you don't pick up the shotguns, you can kill him really fast with the slides as well. Yeah, it's good against our boss. I half the time I try it and I miss it. I can do it, but it just sometimes I miss it. I know you can super kill some of the bosses and you can slide through pretty much most of the levels. Seems I never buy cider in cans, that tastes quite nice. A slide is useful sometimes, isn't it, from getting one side of the screen to the other fast as well. I've not played the arcade one very much. I played the Mega Drive one quite a bit. I love the poster on the arcade, it's really cool. Don't tend to do dual monitors, I get my tits off in two screens half a time. Just give me one big screen, I'll do. I know it is quicker to go down by her, but I don't like going down. I don't like fighting the Witch Doctor. Ah, some extra levels there. Nice. This bit can sometimes be a bit of a pain. As long as I didn't get knocked on the hole, it's fine. Yep, okay, you missed me. No! You can do it on the PC, can't you? You probably had the board or something, do you? That's the one difference between the PC and the console one. The PC version, you can do dual screens. Console one, you can't. Damn, I didn't jump far enough in. Oh well. Well, I gather timing. Yep, that was it. I modded our keyboard. It's mad. Yeah, because the arcade red's on 232 inch monitors. I love the arcade one, it's really good. Played that shit loads. Spyro 3 came out in the UK, didn't he? Or didn't he? Oh, I didn't do it. Oh, okay. Remember Rolling Thunder 3 not being that good? I could be wrong, though. My darling! Get it. Oh, okay. Yeah, because it was originally a PSP game. It's a one screen game. Mad that, isn't it? So, you know, technically it was modded to two screens because it was originally a one screen PSP game. I like the PSP version as well, it's really good. The arcade one is way better than the PSP in my mind. I never do this on two hearts, but I'll try it just for the RNG. Maybe it'll be nice to me on one of the other runs. Oh god, two of us, not good. Got me. Okay, I wasn't too bad. Yeah, Spider-Man 2 was good. It was good for a, you know, a home game. I still don't like it as much as the arcade one, mind, but it is a pretty decent home game. And it does have all the stuff of the arcade, essentially. Checking some. Oh, really? Oh, you fucking bastard. Yeah, it's the best. When it just starts checking the ones that shoot across the screen, you know you're in trouble. Yeah, 3's okay. I think 1 and 2 are a lot better. It's not terrible, 3, but I think Golden Axe 2 is pretty decent. Still. Not as good as the arcade one, I suppose, but still pretty decent nevertheless, you know? Oh, come on. Oh, got this one behind me now, which is not gonna. I knew we'd do that then, but he dropped two on me. Last life. I hate this level. This level's like super random. I know sliding this boss, you can kill it faster as well. Don't like him when they get behind me. Right, I haven't checked the double one on me yet, so that's quite good. It was a weird angle, wasn't it? Gonna hit me. Yeah, it's quite good for a console only sequel. It was pretty decent. Street Fighter 3 plays really nice, doesn't it? It's fast, plays nice, got loads of moves and that, but compared to the music on 1 and 2, the music is really bad on it. I don't know what Yuzo was thinking at the time, to be honest. Or smoking. But technically it plays a lot better than the other games. The jumping noise is screwed up on this a little bit as well, if you notice that. Yeah, but it does play nice part for him. It's been nice to me so far. I've not played the third one that much, to be honest. I think it does get a lot of, basically, flack, basically, because of the music. Oh, I couldn't jump in. Can you get that slight delay when you punch? Oh, come off! I jumped too soon. Yeah, it's a cool game, it says. I really like playing it. When I can play it, of course. Yeah, the sounds are a little bit messed up on this bit. Parts of it, I don't seem to too bad, to be honest. I always wanted this, man. I always wanted the arcade board. Let's try again. Yeah, it just plays nice, doesn't it, part 3. Playability wise, it does play a lot faster. Gotta play the Japanese one though. Oh yeah, great. Chuck two of those things right on me. Been very unlucky with the drops. Won't have any of them, is it? I haven't got a boxed version. Or have I got a boxed version? I don't know, I may have. I can't remember. I've got it. But it might be cart only, I can't remember. Oh, didn't keep your eyes closed. Is it a boxed one? Don't know. Can't remember. Okay, connect the rankers. Do you want to connect? It is a nice game. The PC Engine one's really good. Considering, you know, what it was on at the time, it's a very nice... It's a pretty nice conversion. Obviously, it didn't stand a chance of holding up to the arcade run, though, did it, to be honest? Well, we're hitting about that 40-minute mark, guys, where the PC might reset again. I did have my hard drive plugged in, mind. My USB one with the drive I took out my PC and I unplugged it. Maybe it's that's causing the problem. We'll see. So let's have a look. So we've got display. We'll have that. That's cool. Yeah, I wonder what's happening with that. I haven't heard anything about that at the moment. What else we got? HD Rumble. Oh, you can actually select your round. Yeah. Ah, that's the dual fighter track mode. Oh, actually, I should have done my buttons. So on, oh, that's auto fire, nice. The only problem is I want that. It's auto. Fire missiles. I think it does, by the look of it. It said leaderboard upgrade. When I said you could change an option, it did mention you'd be excluded from the leaderboard if you did it. It's a nice arcade game, it is. It's nice on the PC Engine as well. Always good to sacrifice that extra life for the dual ships at the start. Okay. Yeah, it's a cool game.
I missed it. It was cool to have the bonus round, wasn't it, on Tekken and Ridge Racer. Can't remember which one it was on now. It might have been Ridge Racer. Yeah, Galpus is really good as well. No one ever talks about it, do they? I think Galpus may have a little bit more going for it. In mechanics, if you know what I mean. I suppose Gallagher was the one that got quite famous. So I suppose you could learn the patterns on these levels, couldn't you? I was weird when I first played the PC Engine. I was like, oh, it's kind of music, it's a bit odd. But the arcade one doesn't even. This is when you add on Tekken, is it? No, it feels alright actually. Feels like just playing it on MIM. It does feel pretty decent. Shit skis. No, this collection feels pretty nice, pretty decent. I've never actually got that far in this game. That's interesting, you don't get the points for them. Quite like Phoenix as well, that's another one. It's quite similar to this. There's quite a lot of similar games to this one back in the day. Shouldn't have gone flashy. Missed him. Oops, I thought I was saying then. Obviously not. Is that the ships from Boss Canova? Is that Namco as well? I think it was, wasn't it? Well, we haven't had a reset. So maybe it was that hard drive. Maybe we should do it. I'm not gonna do a full format, but yeah, I'll be there all day. Oh, let's go back to that a minute. Hang on. Okay, seems a quite a nice collection, it does. The games seem to play quite well and they look good as well. And you can stretch them out full screen without any dodgy bitty scrolling or anything. Pac-Man. I love the poster, class. It's an NVMe drive. It's the one that was my C drive. I had it plugged in. So I want that as shoot, have that as jump. And I'll have So the Mega Drive version is really cool. Shit. Okay, let's try that again. I need a full size version of that poster. That poster's really cool. Remember how to play us though. Why don't you take it back up? It's a bit sneaky, wasn't he? Wouldn't put his head back up. I was learning the Meg Drive game at one point. Come on, come up here then. Yeah, I do then. Oh, that's cool. The PlayStation 1 collection was quite cool, wasn't it?
You put them all on the side and it spelled out Namco on the discs, which is rather cool. And it's got Legend of Valkyrie on it as well, which is also very nice. This game's almost like elevator action in some ways. But without the elevators, just action. Damn, I shouldn't have stayed on here. That was a bad move. Grenade. Come on, come up here then. Forgot about that. Ah, tricky. Oh, it's out today on Switch, is it? That's a really cool game. Yeah, he's coming to Archives, isn't he? I heard that was the next Archive game. One button. Some number got that. Really like the SNES version of that game. In some ways, I like the SNES version better than the arcade one. I remember I'd see Rolling Thunder everywhere back in the day, and it was always a really hard game. Never lasts very long, innit? You always try and rush it, I suppose, as a kid, being there. It's a game that requires you to take your time. Come on. No, Cosmogan. There's two of them, there's a puzzle version as well, isn't it? It's a pretty nice arcade game. It'd be quite good to practice this game. One of those ones you gotta learn the enemy placements and stuff from new. I've got a full flat up top now. Very similar to the Mega Drive one, though.
Was lucky. Oh, he slapped me. That was naughty. Damn, he fired low. So where did he start me from? Okay. Remember, the purple guy's fire low. Try jumping. How about? Oh my God, that's going crazy. A slow crappy bullet. Rolling Bratwurst. Yeah, go on, bugger off. You're gonna jump up or? I seen that bullet. Roll on, Tavlight. Fun game, guys. I like that game. Yeah, me tree. Sire. Roll on, Sovelai. The time. 11. Let's go back to the menu. What else we got? 1991. Yeah, I played this before. How many times have they released Tank in different forms? So, Spider was class. That's class. It's also good. Sky Kid's not bad. Tower of Dragon's like super popular. I'm not entirely sure why, but it is super popular. Dig Dug, he's a cruel, cruel bastard. I feel sorry for the enemies in this game because he literally puts a pipe in them and blows them up till they explode. Dig Dug is a horrible man. So let's have a go of him. I play part two, that's a bit of an odd one. Yeah, it's quite a good game. It's just, he is an horrible bastard, isn't he? He literally does blow them up until they explode. It just seems wrong. So I'll have that one as fire harpoon. Oh. Yeah. Oh God, man! I've seen a couple of interviews with people who've fallen on. Some guy fell on a it was a lorry. He was unhooking it, and he fell over onto the compressed air hose, and it literally, he said, it blew him up. That somebody, he couldn't get off it, and somebody managed to come across, and push him off it. But he said, literally, he said it lifted my skin off my flesh, all underneath my body. He said it was horrendous. Oh man. Not good. Part two was a bit odd, wasn't it? Yeah, he said it was horrendous. He said he spent weeks and weeks in hospital after. Imagine that, having all your skin literally lifted off your flesh. I got a feeling it wasn't fun. Going. Yeah, it's weird. You got like, but it's a bit puzzling in some ways, isn't it? Because you got to basically, you got to cut the land off as well, haven't you? I didn't understand it the first time I played. I was like, eh? Oh, okay, that was bad. I think once you get your head around it, it's not a bad little game. Oh, I thought I hosed him then. Oh, you pick it off. Okay, kill this thing first. He's doing a run, isn't he? Yeah, it definitely is. It's not a game I've played a huge amount. It's alright. Yeah, I remember Mr. Driller. I want to play that Shovel Knight Dig. That's pretty nice. I bet the world record on this is stupid.
never actually played it. I've seen videos of it. It came with like a bloody vibrating thing or something, didn't it? Or some gyroscope or something. If I remember right, didn't you need that to play it properly? I've seen it. It looks cool. Okay. Well, that's quite a nice collection. That's worth the $5.99 I paid for it. Tanuki Justice seems quite fun as well. I haven't got the cards for them at the moment. They're on the other side of the room. A pocket stuff's nice on you. Cool on the handheld. That won't be much longer. What else did I pick up lately? That's a demo. I got that on the PC anyway. Hazelnut Hex is quite a nice game. Quite a nice shmup. That's alright as well. The Zanic mobile game. I remember when you played that. I bought it. And it's Thunder Strike. That's nice as well. I had that really cheap. I think it's on offer at the moment on the store as well. I'm sure I paid something ridiculous like a quid for it. I haven't really played that much either. It's supposed to be really good though. Oh, I have got Twisted G. Okay. Didn't think I had that. Class. Yeah, that's the ones I've picked up lately-ish. I picked up Tiny Metal as well, which looks good, but I've still never played it. I got stopped buying cheap Switch games and think, oh yeah, that looks cool. For like a pound or so, and then just never playing them. I shouldn't make a point of playing them, so we'll have one go on this, and then I'll call it a night. Ah, it's Bare Bonesy. Yes, it's quite a nice shoot-em-up, is this? Cutesy Witch game. It looks quite nice on the handheld screen as well, because it's nice, big and chunky, if you know what I mean. I think I've done my buttons. Future chance, no. Let's go with that five in. Each level's got like a different colour scheme. Yeah, the spread weapon of the bomb is not that powerful. It's handy, but not great for killing bosses. Hazelnut Hex. Yep, it's definitely in a tele game, you alright. It's quite nice. It is quite a nice game. I don't think it costs that much either. I don't think I paid much for it. I did buy it when it came out. I think it was less than a tenner.
Got her. They should have called it Nutella the Witch, and they should have gone to Nutella and thinking, oh, we're making a game now, we just need to get a license off you, just chuck it on. We'd probably tell them where to go. It's weird that each level's got its own like colour scheme. Fly past that. It's quite sort of cutesy but big and chunky in here, this game. I think that's why it works pretty nice on the handheld. Good night. I want to go up there and kill them, but I don't. Got it. Oh, got full bombs as well. This looks quite nice at a cab actually. But I gotta remember, I got loads of bombs. Should use the bomb. You forget you get good points for that as well. I forgot that's how you score as well with the bombs. Very sort of like minimal visuals, aren't they, on this, but it works. They come down from the ceiling. Hey, Oh yeah, I forgot about this guy. Don't think you can get life spike in this. Ooh, I didn't notice that, man. Yeah, it's a pretty nice game. I don't think it's been released on anything else either. I think it is literally just Switch only at the moment. Yeah, no worries, buddy. I'm gonna shoot soon as well. Yeah, I won't be on Saturday because I'm sort of going out. I'm busy for a change. My mates and I asked me over, so I went, alright. But I'll be on Sunday. But I'll definitely catch you on the weekend on Sunday anyway. But yeah, you take care, man. Cheers for popping in as always. Appreciate it. It's bonus for that as well. I got an extend. Yeah, catch you in. Good night, mate. Wonder when the next Mario Kart tracks are out. The last ones were really good. Ghosts. I was like, I was out of bombs as well. Music's quite cool in this level. Do don't want to stay still, just in case. Well, I gained another bomb. Well, that was a stupid dodge. Didn't get to the bomb in time. Hopefully it's uncontinued. But yay, thank God for that. Should play Abra more, it's quite good fun. Right, anyway guys, it's 11:30. It's time for me to go. So cheers everyone for hanging around. Whoever's left. Any lurkers? Cheers for popping in. And like I said, I won't be on Saturday. I'll be on Sunday. Remember Saturday off for a change. Yeah, cheers by you. Good night as well. Have a good one. I'll catch you on Sunday. Unless things change. But should be fine. Sunday's looking like what I'm going to be going for. Yeah. Still around. Right. Okay. Right then guys, cheers for that, and I'll have a good end, and I'll catch you Sunday. Okay, ta-ra. Right, catch you around. Bye-bye. Good night.